get to have a better understanding how actually Bedok is. Okay, so let me just check whether we are actually online at the moment now. See whether we are actually going live online. So probably we will have take another a few more minutes before we kick start. So first of all, in Bedok, right, is currently the unit that most likely we will be seeing today is a special and unique unit. Okay, I will say that because this cluster is actually a DBSS, which is the only DBSS in the mature estate of Bedok. Okay, and it was the developer was for those who don't really know what is DBSS mean, because DBSS is actually designed and built by private developer. However, of course, it still fall under a HDB scheme. Therefore, the developer for this development is actually a CEL. And the TOP is actually in 2014, okay? So total, there is actually 6 blocks over here. And of course, it's a 99-year lease. So the concept itself is technically, it's just like a condo. You see, you will have balcony area and a large balcony, those modern kind of layout and things like that. So it's exactly the same as a condo unit. The only difference is probably it does not fence up and enclose it. So they don't have their own facilities like swimming pool and et cetera. But however, there is some like barbecue area, children's playground, you know, some pebble walk and things like that. So it's still very cozy and it's also at the heart of the Bedok Reservoir area. So some of the units actually have those reservoir view that is facing. And the best part is today we are seeing a unit that is actually facing the reservoir. So this is something that you will be able to see later on. Just give me a moment, someone actually, okay. Okay, so for those people who are actually using your mobile phone, then you just need to swipe to your left. So by right, you swipe to your left, right, you will be able to see a welcome screen down here, which is a picture of the Belvia. Okay, so if there is any question along the way, right, you feel free to type inside below the chat box. You are able to type your question inside the chat box. Then we will actually will address to it. And of course, if you like to post any question during the walkthrough later on, you can unmute yourself and then raise your concern. Because for us, right, my seller here were very economic. I mean, to help to, you know, show you at which certain part of the house that you want to see. They were, my seller will be very well to help to do so. Okay. So just give me some more minutes because right now I see there is 6 packs over here. Okay. We should begin soon. At the meantime, I just briefly go through with those who are early here that how is the estate in this Belvia itself. So probably continue. This Belvia, right, is actually there's 6 blocks over here. So the total of units here is around 488 units. So it's a mixture of 3-room, 4-room, and 5-room. So the unit that we are seeing for today, right, is a 5-room unit. So, and it's part of the largest unit itself, because 5 rooms, there's 2 types. So it's from 105 square meter to 109 square meter. So this unit today we will be seeing is the biggest one, which is the 109 square meter. And part of the uniqueness here is they have 2 ensuite. So that's mean what does this mean? Ensuite is like they come with their own attached bathroom. The bathroom, the bedroom itself, they have an attached bathroom. So on there is two. There's three. This unit, they have two master bedroom, something like that. They have ensuite for two. So without further ado, let me just double check. So for those who are using your laptop, right, then you can just click on, you can click on my screen, Ron Loh, and then at the top right hand corner, right, you click the dot, right, then you can, they will pop up a thing called pin video. When you click on the pin video, you are able to see the main screen here. So far, so good. So if let's say you guys, if have any questions, I just repeat myself again. Any question, you can just type in the chat box, okay? And then if you want to ask certain question during the walkthrough, you also can choose to unmute yourself and raise your question. And then we will help to show you at certain part of the unit itself. Then you can have a better look at the virtual viewing. Okay, without further ado, probably I will just kick start already because to. So good afternoon, everyone. So a very big thank you for tuning in for today open house at Block 747C, Bedok Reservoir Crescent. So this is actually DBSS Belvia is the only DBSS in Bedok itself lah. Okay, TOP is in 2014. Okay, total there is 6 blocks. Okay, the highest floors is actually 14 and 15. So today the unit that we will be seeing is on the 12th floor. It's considered high floor. Okay, later on we will show you more. Okay. And then at the meantime, I will let my seller to relax for a while actually for some benefit or doubt, I will go through some of the surrounding and amenities with those who are really not familiar with this area. Okay, so at the meantime, we will just let seller to take a short break. Okay, so over here, you're supposed to be able to see the slides. So now, the slide that I'm showing you at this moment of time is actually the site plan. You'll be able to see the DBSS Belvia site plan. So these are the 6 blocks over here. You can see my cursor. So 747A, 747B, 747C. So today we will be seeing this block itself, 747C. And the stack is actually one of the best stack that can overlook the entire reservoir area, and it's the closest to the reservoir, in fact. Okay. Then, of course, behind you can see the list out of the drop off point, you know, footpath, and things like that. It's all at the back of the block itself. And there's a multi story car park down there. Okay. So, this is overall some of the how the house looks like from the living area. So, you can see it's a very wide frontage. Is a very wide frontage and a large balcony at the living hall. Okay, so from here you can see a glimpse of how the reservoir view looks like. Okay, and then I show you some pictures. So there's an unblocked view. Rest assured, in front of you, because it's a low rise. Okay, there is like McDonald's 24 hours, Sheng Shiong. And NTUC, likewise, is also 24 hours, and some eateries and things like that. So rest assured, also there won't be, I would say that don't have future development will build in front of you that block your view lah. You see, so that is the plus point. You will have this view lah. Okay. So this is how the rooms looks like. Okay, later on we will actually see the life how it is. Okay, and if you notice on the first picture, right. There's a balcony and a master room. So that is also part of the uniqueness in this unit itself, okay? And you come along with an enclosed kitchen. Because hardly nowadays, I mean for private or whatever, sometimes they hardly will have an enclosed kitchen for some newer developments, okay? So this top picture is actually the ensuite at another side. So later on, we will see that as well. So now, the location, okay? So I just quickly go through where the location is. So this is the block that we will be seeing, circle in blue, okay? And then just right across is just now what I have shared with you where all the amenities is. you have a NTUC Sheng Shiong, a big coffee shop, some eateries and cafes and bars and as well. Okay, so it's quite a cozy area. And then if you just cut across, right, the amenities there, right, it's actually the reservoir park already, where it's quite famous for people who living in the east, lah. So they will know about this reservoir park. You know, it's quite popular among the joggers, and also for those who like water sport activities, usually will held over here. Okay. Then the nearest MRT station will be Bedok North MRT station, which is the downtown line. Okay, so it's approximately around, I would say that it's about 11 or 12 minutes walks. Later on, I will share with you in the next slides. I actually has used Google Map to give the exact walking distance, how far it is from this block to the station. Okay, so the two circles that I actually plot out, right, is also another so-called amenities, wet market and hawker center. So these are the two locations which also nearby. You can take either a feeder bus, or if let's say the one that you saw below, right, the 500 series here, you can actually walk. You can just from there walk across to the behind the park connector and cross over the overhead bridge from at the PID there, and you can actually reach this area. There's also another Sheng Shiong over there as well. There's hawker center and wet market. Okay, then the school is nearby. School is around like the Damai Secondary. Of course, there's primary as well, and there's some international school. So in terms of school wise, right? Okay, just quick one. Within 1 to 2 kilometer, you can see these other school will be surrounding the area lah. So Damai Primary, Fengshan Primary, Opera Estate, Red Swastika, okay, Telok Kurau Primary, and Yunnan. So it's all around this radius, 1 to 2 kilometer for schools, okay. And then for the walking distance, so it's about 10 minutes walks to the MRT station. So this one I actually plot out from the Google Map itself lah. So it's the Bedok North MRT station, which is the nearest, okay. It's a downtown line, blue color line, okay. So for those who are, you know, familiar with this line, whether it be your workplace or whatever, then that will be how. It's also almost all sheltered lah, along the way to the MRT station. Okay, so this is the layout. As you can see from here, the layout from the entrance coming in, you can see. Then this part is actually the ensuite. Okay, it's another ensuite. And then further here is actually a master bedroom. It's also an ensuite. So there is actually 3 bathrooms. If you notice, 1 bathroom here. At the center, there's a common bathroom. And at the master room, there's another bathroom. So there's 3 bathrooms in this unit itself. So while the uniqueness is what? While the uniqueness is you can convert this layout into a dual concept unit. So example, if let's say you are just a startup family, a couple, young couple, or probably with 1 kids or whatever, you actually can do something like this, which I'm going to show you here. You can do up an entrance. You see an arrow there. I can actually seal up here or with an entrance, okay? And then this portion, right, it will become a standalone 1 bedder. You can see, because here there's a door. Ma. So you go in here, this area, you can do something like a dry kitchen and plus laundry, because they have their own attached bathroom over here. And there's wardrobe, and behind here, you can put your bed. So it's like a 1 bedder. So if let's say your family size is not that big, just a small family, you can do something like a Duel-Key concept. This is what I mean. So this is another portion, because once you seal up, this is the entrance going into the house. So this is like a 2 bedder by itself. So you just need to do a door here only. So it becomes a 2 bedder here. So there's 2 bedrooms over here and an enclosed kitchen with a yard and the living area. So that is something, you know, that some families can be done this way. But if let's say you have more people to stay together, then of course you will need the entire house to to utilize, fully utilize lah. Okay, so this is the direction which is facing north. Okay. So to touch on some uniqueness over here, some USP selling point, total unblocked spectacular view of the Bedok Reservoir. Okay, it's actually just right in front of you. The unit itself, I would say that it's one of the best that with the better facing in terms of this Belvia itself. Okay. And then the unit will have two ensuites. So it's either you can convert it into a dual key, or if let's say you are staying with your parents, so you have two master bathrooms. So probably parents can stay at one bedroom as well with their own attached bathroom. So unit have two cozy balcony at the living hall and the master room. And unit is on the high floor with no afternoon sun. So that is what I want to cover so far. Let's let me see. I will welcome my seller back, because before we kick start, right? So Shirley, you are there? Can you hear me?
Yeah,
so I'm actually done with the amenities and some key selling point of the development lah.
Yeah.
So would you want to add on anything so far?
No, I think basically we stay here for 5 years, and it's a very good area. We've been very comfortable here.
Okay, let me see. Okay, let me just turn on. Give me a second. I try to pin your video so that the audience, the guests should be able to see your screen.
Okay.
Okay. Let me see. Give me a second. So, let me see. Can anyone actually see my seller screen, which is actually standing at the doorstep now? Can you guys actually see that? No? Give me a second. Okay, so guys, do you actually now able to see my seller screen? You can type inside, because I cannot see you guys. So probably if you can see my seller screen, right, you can just type inside the chat box so that I know you all are seeing the screen now. Okay. Thank you. I see someone respond already. Thank you so much. So you all can see my owner screen. That's good. So now, so I like to thank you, my seller, for taking up her time, you know, to help us to, you know, to do this live virtual tour for us, so that we can actually view the house remotely. Okay, so shall we begin?
Sure.
Okay, So guys, if anything of during this workshop, if anything, right, you can just feel free to unmute yourself to ask question, or you can actually just type inside the chat box. We will actually answer accordingly. Okay, we shall start down here. So now we are actually standing at the entrance. You can see from here, entrance of the unit. So once we come in, right, okay, we can see there's the door over there, and this is the portion that is okay. Now my seller actually is going into the ensuite. Okay. Now this angle, right, is actually the one that I mentioned just now, that you can convert it into a dry kitchen plus laundry, and there's a master bathroom over there where you can see. Yeah. So this is how the bathroom looks like. Okay. It was actually done by the developers lah. Okay, so now we are actually going to the bedrooms. Okay, so this is the how the bedroom looks like. Okay, you can see from here. There's a built-in wardrobe there. Okay. Okay, Shirley, probably we can show them how the view looks like now.
Okay.
Okay, if possible.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is the view from this bedroom. It's, later on, you will see it's the almost the same view with the balcony area at the living hall, which in front of you is actually unblocked all the low-rise amenities down there. Okay. Now we probably you just turn around to show them the space of the, yeah. Yes, good. So you slowly turn to your left, yes. So that they can see the space, yes. So this is how it looks like for this bedroom. Okay, and then there's a wall-mount TV down there. The built-in over there, that's the entrance that we come in from just now. Okay, and there's an aircon down there with a wardrobe. Okay, thank you. So we shall proceed to, probably we have another glance of this area.
This area, okay.
Yes. So this is the area that we just also can do up. Because right now you can see my seller actually do up a study area down there. So it's what you can do, that you can build up a dry kitchen if you wish to rent it out as a one-bedder unit. It can be done so. So it's like a one-bedder plus a two-bedder and another side. Yes. Okay. So we shall proceed to the another unit. So now we are coming into the entrance here. Huh? Straight away we come in is actually the enclosed kitchen. So from here you can see both sides. My seller actually have two tabletop down there, the kitchen top and bottom cabinets. And the fridge is just right beside us on the left. Okay. And then straight ahead, right, is actually the yard area. Okay, so the yard area is enclosed as well where you can do the laundry. So over here, Masala is actually showing you how the view looks like. It's facing towards the east. So it's also an unblocked view. It's very windy. You can see the skies and things like that. Because it's higher, you know, it's higher than the other HDB blocks.
The neighboring blocks.
Yeah, so that's why it's not blocked. Okay. Okay, provisionally you can just turn around. Yes, good. Yeah, so now you can see how it looks like from the entrance all the way coming into this enclosed kitchen. In fact, my seller actually very well maintained the kitchen. You can see it's pretty, I would say it's pretty like from day one, the condition. Okay, of course, if let's say for those who are the guests who are here today, if let's say you would like to arrange another physical view, it can be done so. We will arrange another physical view for you privately. Okay. So now we head to the living hall. Okay, so this is the main living hall. Okay, now we're coming to here. Okay, so we can just probably show here. So this we just hold for a while. So this is exactly like how our picture looks like, as you can see from just how the slide that I go through with you guys. So you have a large, you know, wide frontage and a living area, okay, a sliding door, okay, all the way to the balcony, a large balcony. Okay, someone have asked, possible to make the kitchen wall glass. So I will say that later on, probably I will touch on this through the floor plan. Okay, because probably from the floor plan we can able to see, because there's only part of the portion is not connected. Okay, later on I will share with you on the floor plan. So probably from here, right, we can take a look at the view at the balcony area. Thank you.
Yeah.
So today weather is also pretty nice. So you can see not recently have been raining quite a few days. So yeah, you can see that is how it looks like. The entire reservoir view. So beautiful. And rest assured, there won't be any more development in front of you. So low rise. Okay. So we just turn back. The camera just turn back. Okay. So this is how the living hall look like. So just saw that this is where the entrance we came in, and then coming to the hall itself. And then beside, we can see the common bathroom entrance, and there is a bomb shelter. The black color is actually a bomb shelter, which is the usually people use it as a storeroom lah. So now we are actually heading towards there. Okay. Now we come to the common bath. Common bathroom is the exactly the same as the developer was provided. Okay, this with the shower screen. And then now we are turning around to look at another room. So this is another common bedroom, which currently my son is actually using it for their children. So there's a built-in wardrobe there. Okay. Yeah, pretty much the same. Yeah, someone is asking. Okay, someone have asked the bomb shelter is between the living room and the kitchen. Yes. Later on, I will share with you the layout again so you have a better understanding. After the virtual viewing, I will share with you once again the layout to let you have a more better understanding how it looks like. Okay, now probably we proceed to the master room. Okay. So this is how the master room looks like. Likewise, the attached bathroom. Okay. And then this is how the master room come with a balcony. Yeah, very cozy. So you have the same view lah. You have the same view as the living hall. Yes. Yeah. Okay, the unit, someone asked, the unit don't have west sun. Okay. Yeah. Because it's facing north, so slightly there is north and morning sun. Some morning sun will from the side as well. Okay, probably we can just turn back and show them the master room from this angle. Yeah, yes, thank you. Okay, so you can see how the space looks like. There's a built-in there. You can able to fit in your queen size bed, the master bathroom. Because nowadays bathroom, there's some guideline like that wheelchair friendly. That means wheelchair must be able to enter. So that's why you will notice the bathroom is actually quite huge. Nowadays, I mean younger flats are all quite similar. Okay. Probably we proceed back to the living hall. Have a last look at the space over here. Okay, so this is how the space looks like. Unblock view. So far, anyone have to see any part of the unit? If not, I will let my seller rest a while. Then I will touch on, because guests over here are asking about the layout. So probably I will touch on that. Okay, someone have also asked if to make a dual key, where to divide. Okay, I will have to touch on the layout already. So if that's the case, give me a second. I will let my seller rest a while first. Okay, Shirley, you can rest a while.
Okay, thank you. I stopped the video.
Thank you. You can turn off your
video.
Your screen.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, I probably just. So I believe you guys are able to see the screen, my screen now. Are you able to see my? Okay, wait. Just double check. Just double check again. Okay, I can't see the chat box. So if you all have to ask me something, you all have to unmute yourself because I click the chat box. The chat box didn't pop up. Okay, so I might not be able to answer your question already. So now probably I just touch on again the layout. Okay, so just now someone have asked a question. If let's say to convert into a dual key, so this is how it looks like. Okay, the arrow down here, you just need to do a door here. So from the main entrance coming in, from here, go in is a two bedder. Then here is like a standalone one bedder ready. So you can rent out this unit itself for some passive income or help you with your installment. So for another question, if just now someone have asked that whether can do a glass panel at the kitchen, right? So you can see this portion here, my mouse that moving here, is the bomb shelter. So normally people use it as a storeroom. So if you want to do glass panel, probably it's only here. It's this portion, which is a very little portion that you can do it here. But personally, I find that it doesn't really make sense. So you might also need to, you can actually have the option to, you know, remove it and then you just do it somewhere here. So if you want a glass panel facing the living hall, I believe it's not able to do so. So that is something that is a bit different. Or if let's say if you need a bigger space, right? In fact, you can hack away this wall or you can hack away here so that you have a bigger space here. Also can. Yeah. So this is how it looks like. If you convert the room to a dual key concept, it will be something like this. So there's one bedder over here, a two bedder over there on the other side. Yes. Okay. So yeah, I can't see the chat room, so that's why I don't know. Okay, so I just move on. So there's been okay. So before we end, I just want to touch on once again. So the uniqueness of this stack itself, because for those people who have actually saw some of the units in Belva that is selling, normally they don't have really direct facing the reservoir view. Okay, it's either they're facing the archipelago, that's mean along the 747, either they're facing archipelago or they're facing the NTUC that side. So this one is actually at the extreme corner, which you have an unblocked view of the reservoir. Okay, it's high enough. Okay, so and of course, the unit can be converted into a dual key concept with two ensuites. Okay, and unit is two cozy balcony at the living hall and the master room. Yeah, so that's all I think I will come to the end of this presentation. Once again, I want to thank you, my seller, Shirley, for showing us her beautiful home today, you see. So
welcome.
Anything you want to add on?
Nothing much.
Nothing much, huh? So I want to thank you once again for everybody to come in today for our open house. So this unit is actually at Block 747C. Bedok Reservoir Crescent, DBSS Belvia, which is a 5-room. So far, we have conducted a few viewings here before already, and we have expected some offer to come in as well. Okay, so if let's say, given this unit, the uniqueness, and we're also expecting it can be, you know, taken up very soon. So if for you guys who are actually come with your agent, please revert to your agent real quick. Or if you are a direct buyer, you may come back to me for any questions. Okay. So since I have answered all the questions Q&A for today, I think I wish everyone have a great day. Stay safe and don't miss this opportunity to own this lovely flat. Okay. So if not, then I will see you in the next viewing. Okay. Or you can PM me for another physical viewing of this unit itself. Okay. If not, then till then, I'll see you guys again. Bye bye. Thank you for everyone. Thank you. Bye bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.